So, TF2. I have finally hit 500 hours after playing on and off for, well, since the game came out on the Orange Box. So technically, I'm not a free-to-play player, though I did start off as a free-to-play because I didn't pay for the Orange Box, technically. I just want to go over some things I've learned in my very small career. I know some people have like thousands and thousands of hours. But yeah, so this isn't going to be great for anyone but me. So, what have I learned? Well, first things first, loadouts. It's always important. Doesn't matter if you don't have the best items. All that matters is that you know how to use them. So, I have medic. Medic is my class I play. I don't play him as a full-on medic, though I play him as a battle medic. And you may notice that I have a strange loadout. I have my Blutsauger, which I'm not gonna lie, it has saved my life more than once. For those people who are still using something like the Overdose, I would advise investing in a Blutsauger or just getting the achievement to get one. I have all of them. Mediguns, I only ever use the Uber and the Quick Fix, depending on what type of situations I'm on. If I'm on a attacking team, I tend to have the Uber because, well, it's you can invulnerability is really useful. But if you have got a large group of people and you're the only medic, and being invulnerable isn't an issue, the Quick Fix is excellent for that because you can just flash around heals really quickly. You can't do that so easily with the Uber. And last but least, I have just a normal bone saw. I don't have any of these. I never got on with them, and I don't. If I've gone down to my melee, something's gone really wrong because the Blutsack is always out first. Though I do have a slightly different loadout for when I'm playing medieval mode because I still do that. Where, okay, why do I have that? I should have that on. That's what happens when you combine items. It mucks up what you've got set up. But I just have the Crusader's Crossbow because it's medieval mode, I can use it. That's just there because it is. You can't use that, sadly. And the Amputator because when all that fails, you hide yourself in a corner and hit taunt like there's n you've never seen it before. I do, of course, have the annoying some the medic taunts, because why not? The other class I play a lot is sniper. I'm not as good as I used to be. I lost some talent for that, but I have the Bizarre Bargain. For me, it was just the easiest one rifle to get used to, and also the head counter, which I really do love. So I got finally brought myself a new one. Though obviously, I do switch for the fortified compound in medieval mode. Though I don't have something set up for that because I don't medieval mode sniper that often. The carbine's cleaner, sorry, the cleaner's carbine. I know people prefer things like the Jurati and the Razorback or even the Darwin's Danger Shield, but personally, I don't really use the secondary. Say, if there's something that close to me, it's great straight to the Tribalman Shiv, which I still can't work out if it is the best weapon. I just like the bleeding for when I'm against the buys, because as a sniper that tends to be the issue. I know the Bushwhacker and the Shash and Jaff, however you say it, have interesting properties as well. And obviously the just a Curie is the Curie. Yeah, so they're the two main classes I play. Often I go to Engineer, though I just have the I'm not gonna lie. Unless you're just using mini sentries, why wouldn't you have the Rescue Ranger? I mean, I understand a Frontier of Justice useful. You do get the crits, but if your nest is going down and you're with it, that's gonna become useful. Sorry, useless, because you're gonna die and you lose your crits. The Widowmaker is good, but I always find you never gain more ammo. It'd have to be an extremely good shot to break even. And the panic attack, I did use that for a while until I got a rescue ranger. I did enjoy it. since you can just, yeah, you just load it up and then fire, you don't have to worry about that. The Wrangler is a must for me because the short circuit is meh. Yeah, it's just, once again, you're using metal, which you don't want to be doing, but something that you probably shouldn't be doing anyway. I mean, the pistol's basic if you do want to have something that actually causes damage, but the Wrangler's always good because all else fails, you can get yourself out of trouble. I just have the basic wrench. I sometimes do go off to the gunslinger if I'm just playing with minis, but I did use the 7.5 speciality on a, for a while because once again the bleeding effect great for against spies, but you know the no random crit hurts a bit, and also the fire damage that hurt a lot. But the Uruk effect and the Jag are both good for those people who play it. But you say this is just what I use. As I said at the start. If you're good with something, even if it's not what everybody thinks is great, I mean, if you're a pyro and you use the flog because you just happen to be good at the flog, I personally don't like the flog against it or with people using it because, as a medic, which is as I mentioned, what I usually play, more than once I've been stood there, bare death, and the only pyro is a flog when you go, well, I'm gonna die in a second because there's no health kit nearby. So, though it is fun to, Uber a flog pyro after they've nerfed because the enemy team know they just there's nothing they can do. Talk about pyro. My once again my setup quite easy. I've finally named my rain blower. So just rain blower. I know it's not anything great, but I get the extinguishing which restores 10 health, which I think it's good because it persuades new pyros to do something other than just WM1. I'm not gonna lie, I tend to WN2 as well, especially up against rockets. The flare gun, I think there are better objects. I mean, especially with the new thermal thrusters and gas passer, I just didn't get used to using them, and I prefer to have the flare gun just in case. And the power jack. Now, so I've been playing with the power jack for a bit, but what I like the fact you get the movement speed. That's mainly what I use it for. And also, in a quick melee fight, if you kill someone, you get the 25 health. But you are more vulnerable. And quite frankly, I like more like the Neon Annihilator or the Homewrecker where I can remove sappers for engineers. But yeah. So, for most of the ones I do use usually a lot, I have a loadout for over here. Well, but yeah, so it's just things. As I mentioned, I often play Battle Medic, which means that I'm doing very little healing. But that's because, and I play Capture the Flag maps a lot, and quite frankly, you don't need a medic on most of those maps. It's only if you've got really good, if the enemy's got really good sentry placement, that you may need a medic, but you don't. And because of that, allows me to have some freedom to muck around. There's nothing more fun than going up on 2-4 and sneaking behind snipers and slowly killing them off, and they're going, wait, there's a spy nearby? No, it's a medic with a bone saw. Oh. Hence my 177 kills with just the bone saw. But yeah, so I like to be able to muck around a medic, and I really appreciate when people don't go bugging me because I'm not healing them on a Capture the Flag map. But on things like payload, yeah, I'd be healing most of you. But you have to remember, there's 12 of you, well, 11 of you, and one of me. And if there is only one medic, don't get your panties in a twist when I'm not healing you. There's 10 other dudes I'm trying to get done at the same time. And it really sucks because you get whined at and you're going, okay, I didn't realise you were the star of the show. Excuse me as I tried to keep our teammates alive. I had that issue, someone saying, oh, if you just Ubered me, we could get this over and done with. In the end, they were not the person we Ubered, and they were not the person who got it over and done with. Spy. I wish I was better at Spy. I really do. It's a fun class. I've been mucking around with it recently. Just got a Dead Ringer set up because it's just the easiest map watch to use. No, I do like the Cloak and Dagger. It's just, yeah, the Dead Ringer is slightly more useful. Though it does drive everyone up a bit up the wall, sorry. I've just got the Kunai and the Lutron J because It's just what I have. Yeah, a lot of my classes I'm limited to what I have. So it's only really four I've purposely decked out. I have decked out Scout a tiny bit. Why have I still got that equipped? I just use the Atomizer. But yeah, so that's just what I use on a day to day when I'm playing. But the things I've learned over the 500 hours. One of the important things is when you want to go to Man vs. Machine, don't be afraid to tick this button, the join game in progress. There's a lot of time you'll join in at like the second or the third round, which means there's already enough cash so you can get the upgrade you're used to. Not to mention, there's probably a group that's been really struggling because they've had a stubborn member who finally left, and you can have nice. Though at the same time, you do have to understand that there is a chance that you're going to join a team that's absolutely hopeless. When I joined one, everyone's an engineer, and you're going, I guess that would work if you moved your sentries so they weren't in one area. Oh, look, you all blew up because of a sentry buster. That happens. I don't play many of the maps, but don't. I only really play Decoy and Cold Town. I've played them all, it's just those are the two that I am used to. But yeah, never be afraid to try out the other ones. Even if you don't think you're going to do well, there's a 85% chance that you're going to be with four other players who are good and will allow you to muck around. Also, if you've got that one person who's being stubborn on your map game, they're choosing one class that you want to be, and it's one of those classes like Scout, sorry, not Scout, like, well, Scout's one of them, but Sniper and Spy. And you don't necessarily any need you, in my opinion, for most maps, you only need one of them, and at any one time, you do not need someone being both a sniper and someone else being a spy, because then you're down to only three heavy hitters. Though, if you're good at it, and you know that you're good, obviously don't be cocky, but you know you can do it well. Play it. Unless you failed the round, don't listen to people complaining at you. Because I've won games on like Cold Town or whatever with multiple snipers. Shouldn't be possible, but we did it. And so, but if you get someone who is being stubborn and you were the best, be the bigger person. You change your class to something else you're good at. Say I was trying to do a heavy contract once on the not contract, heavy achievement on MVM, and I mean that's fine, multiple heavy is not too much of a problem, but the engineer then changed to another class, and then we had tons of heavy hitters, but we had problems with getting people to the front lines because the heavier hitter, the slower you are. So I changed up to engineer, and with that we managed to complete the game. Now I'm just saying, those scouts and man works hardest level on normal difficulty. Okay, what else have I learned? Let's think. I don't go on community servers too much. I do on the occasion if I've got a friend who wants to go on them, but I'm more into casual. I should have this unlocked, but I can't be bothered to go through the process, nor can I be bothered to pay. So that's it. But training. Now, I'm not gonna lie. Unless you're really new. Yeah, no, just don't bother with this. It'll only teach you the real basics, but in an environment that you won't learn. So sure, play through it once, get to know the classes, understand where the button presses are, but no. But don't be afraid to go on offline practice. The bots are predictable, which is useful, but it's like you get certain maps and you get used to the maps themselves, placements and all that. I'm not gonna lie, I used to play a lot of Viaduct on offline mode when I was younger because I was the 12-year-old with a microphone, and not that I was the whiny 12-year-old with a microphone, cause I had a microphone, I thought I should use it, but I had no confidence to do it with online, so I just practiced on there. And also, it's great because you can leave at any point. And you can dominate people at any point and they don't get salty. What I find amusing is that I hadn't played it in probably since about 200 hours. had. I was playing it the other day and I managed to dominate every bot. And I'm going, I mean, I know it's not useful, but I feel slightly achieved that I managed to do that. I was playing engineer. Turns out bots are stupid. But casual. Say, don't be afraid to try a new map. I have my favourites, you all have your favourites. But don't be afraid to try something a bit different. And also, however you act in one game mode, don't act in another. I mean, capture the flag, as I mentioned earlier. Medic isn't really used that often. I wouldn't say he's a useful class in capture the flag, unless you've got well-armed defences. You wouldn't. And also, like, sniper, in a lot of the capture the flag maps, sniper places are pretty much in the same place every time. It's very rare you'll see a sniper in somewhere interesting. Though, that sniper who decided to hide in the sewers in 2-foot, god, the amount of times he got my head, because I wasn't expecting it. But yeah, so you would never stand in one place on any of the other maps. You wouldn't stand there when playing Payload in the same place throughout the whole game, because the enemy would be on the other side of the map. If you're a medic, and this hurts me to say, no matter how much of a vast medic you are, no matter how good you are, no matter how many hours you've played or how many points you got just from killing people, remember your teammates. Even on times when I don't, it's Team Fortress 2, it's in the title, but even on maps like when I play the Capture the Flag Star ones, and you don't need heals, I'll still flash healing around if I see people low on health. I'm not going to ignore you. Unless you're whining at me in the chat about not healing. And then I'll take note of your name and ignore you. But the same is for your teammates. Don't unnecessarily spam medic. If you don't actually need healing, don't spam it. If you're only spamming it so a medic will pocket you, no. Don't. And same with medics. Don't be feel like into bully being you're being bullied into healing one person. You're not. You shouldn't. And let's face it, you choose who lives and dies. They don't. Well, they choose who dies, but you can choose who in your teammates live or die. So, the power is in your hands. Don't bottom for them. So, I've only got, like, I know I don't have 500 hours racked up. That's because I played an offline mode at the start, so it's obviously lower, and I don't know if it racks up your MVM playtime. But yeah, so just don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I mean, I've got quite a bit of damage as a medic, and yeah, my scores aren't amazing. Say a lot of you would know it better. Let's see, what other class can I talk about? Sorry, I mainly play. I'm a medic main, but I play other classes. Say engineers. You're a dispenser, right? So, you should put it somewhere useful for your team. But don't forget, you need access to it as well. There's no point setting it so far away from you that you can't ensure that it's going to survive. And you can't ensure that you can get the metal from it. Especially if you set up your sentry where there's no metal pack. You're going to need your metal to keep your sentry alive. But, yeah. So don't feel like you have to... Never feel like you have to listen to being told how to play your class. A lot of the time you'll be told how to play by a person who doesn't know the class. Or they only have a couple of hours in. Like, I don't even have an hour in heavy. I don't really like I'm useless at these three classes. I've been aimed to be a soldier recently, but I'm no good at them. So I'm not going to go as to fact spy as well. I'm not going to go and tell someone how to play spy. This does not mean you can't write in chat saying, oh hey, could someone go do that? Go take down the sentry, go take down that sniper, whatever. And this is... So that's that. But yeah, medic I've whined about, engineer I've whined about, sniper I've whined about. Pyro, please remember air blasting's a thing. You may not think it's important, but... extinguishing enemies and rockets. If you're being a pyro and you're not air blasting rockets away from the sentry, you're not doing your job. Sorry about that hideous sound. That's the sound of a phone ringing and me trying to get up and deal with it. But yeah. Is there anything else I need to add? I think there's one more thing I wanted to say. People with headsets. Now, I know there's tons of you out there. I know it's really cool to be able to talk to your team. But please, 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 don't spam random noises, badly played music. Anything, don't, like, belittle people. Don't yell, don't shout, don't overly swear. Well, I've got a problem with swearing. It's just when you do, it tends to be because you're whining. Don't. Because quite frankly, if you're whining and you're playing a team game, you're not doing it right. Okay, I understand occasionally you're going to be with bad players. Don't tell them off. Help them out. Like, I know people think my setup's bad. Like, I don't even have the sandwich yet. I got told off not throwing it out. Go! I have nothing to throw out apart from a chocolate bar. It's practically useless. So yeah. Just don't. Be nice. I understand that sometimes you'll need to tell people off that don't. And also, don't be afraid to give details if you've got a headset on and nobody else is talking. Because you'll probably find that there's four of people on your team all sat there going, don't want to be the first person to talk. So yeah, feel free to use your headset. Do it. Just be polite, be efficient, and be just remember that some people may not be playing with their headset on, and there could be other people in the room. And if you start playing sexual sounds down the mic, it's going to be weird. So, yeah. I think that's it. All that I've learnt, a little bit, so I know about after 500 hours. Hopefully getting on to more. Technically, I think I'm on 500 at the start of this video. I'm still on 500 on the exact, but I got convinced to play Team Fortress 2 overnight. I said convinced. Someone say, oh, I'm going to play TF2. I'm like, sure, I'll come join you. They weren't even asking me to join. But I did. Oh, yeah. Don't underestimate, so my final little tidbit, don't underestimate someone who doesn't have cosmetics. Just because they've only got, like, ghostly, the gibbous and, I don't know, pyrovision goggles, does not mean that they're going to be naff. I'm trying to see if I have that actually yet, still. Yeah, no, I don't. But yeah, it doesn't mean they're going to be bad players. A lot of the time there'll be older players who are just in disguise or very new players. Don't be mean to them if they're struggling. Help them out. You see an engineer who's constantly being wrecked because of poor sentry placement. Suggest them to hide it around the corner a bit more or something if you've played engineer or not and you know what you're talking about. If you see a medic that's being effectively a pincushion, give them some advice. Feel free. Don't whine. Don't be mean. Because it's just, it ruins the game for everyone if everyone has to listen to a domestic over microphones or in the chat. And also, don't forget, binds are fun. Bind. As in that little button. I have my own bind. It's special. If you ever see me in a game and something happens, you'll see my bind pop up. Binds are special. Please don't spam them. Anyway, so that's it. It's sort of my boring video, but it's something I've decided to do. But yeah, so. Liked if like. I probably won't do anything else like this again, because I don't do TF2 too often. Well, I don't think there's much I can do apart from playthroughs, so I'm not that good. But feel free to check out my Forager playthroughs. And my Stardew Valley mod reviews, because they're what I tend to do. At the moment, I've got a lack of content, which is why I just did this video, really. Because there's not many mods to review. Not ones that you can actually review. So yeah. Anyway. Tell me I'm awesome if you think I'm awesome. Tell me I'm terrible if you think I'm terrible. Feel free to comment and subscribe. This is Miss C signing off. Goodbye.